Now let's modify in here. So I'm going to grab each one of these corners and we're going to modify the radius. This is going to get changed to 0.075 for each corner. So click, enter the new number, and then enter twice. Now we just need to move in the sides. Again, just kind of using simple movement tools, making this very easy to use. Okay, with everything moved, I'll hit escape. Let's turn off these toolpaths for a moment. Notice that you can really see a difference between what the feature is currently showing and the wireframe. And under our solids, we will see that it's all dirty. But something else to keep in mind is because of the way I've set up this solid, I only have to update one of these faces. That's because instead of modeling my wireframe for every feature, I have three identical features that are evenly spaced, which means I can use patterns inside of my solid to create the features around the part. So I created circular patterns for my flats, pockets, and holes, and then I just program one set of flats, pockets, and holes. So when I regenerate my single changes here, I'll actually see all of those changes happen all around the part. They all match up, they're all done perfectly. At this point, my toolpaths are again dirty because we changed the solid model. But because it's tied to the solid edges themselves, which have been modified, I now have all of my toolpaths perfectly clean, everything's working exactly the way that it should with all of the same parameters.